Simha Kriya. In questi tempi insolitamente difficili di pandemia globale, avere un sistema immunitario forte e un sistema respiratorio ben funzionante assume un'importanza fondamentale. Le antiche tecniche yogiche sono conosciute per avere molti benefici sul corpo, mente e energie. Ecco un'offerta da Sadhguru, uno yogi, mistico e visionario. Sadhguru offre Simha Kriya, una semplice ma potente pratica yogica per rafforzare le difese immunitarie e per migliorare la nostra capacità polmonare. Questa pratica può essere fatta da tutti, con alcune eccezioni specificate nel video delle istruzioni per la pratica. Specialmente per coloro che non hanno un altro potente processo per sostenere il loro sistema durante questi tempi, Simha Kriya può essere estremamente benefico. Sadhguru darà le istruzioni. È importante che tu riceva queste istruzioni correttamente. Per favore, dedica i prossimi 10 minuti esclusivamente a questo processo. Per favore, non provare la pratica mentre stai guardando il video. Ascolta prima tutte le istruzioni e poi prova la pratica da solo.
So this is a simple practice. This is not relevant to people who are doing Shakti Chalana Kriya. It's not necessary to do this. But it could be done if you're doing Shakti Chalana Kriya in the morning, in the evening. You can do it, or in the afternoon if you're hungry enough, you can do it. Otherwise, for those of you who do not know any other powerful process, this will help. One thing is, it will enhance your lung capacity. Another thing is, it'll enhance your immunity. And above all, if you can do it today, if you can do it for next 5 days, and suddenly one day you're not able to do it, this means definitely you got some respiratory problem. It may not be this particular one virus, but it could be anything else. It doesn't matter what it is, you must have yourself checked if you suddenly find you're not able to do it. What it involves is that you have to fully stretch your tongue out with your mouth fully open, and then breathe as powerfully as possible without jerking the abdomen, but powerful pushing in and pushing out, both inhalation, exhalation, 21 times. And when it is done, you roll up your tongue upward, push it as further back as you can. You don't have to use your hands, this is not a good time to use your hands. So roll up your tongue fully as much as you can by yourself, like, and still with your mouth open, again breathe the same way. Inhalation, exhalation as powerfully as possible, but you must get the sound by making a constriction in your throat like this. The sound must be there. It's important that you make, form a constriction at the throat level, at the pit of your throat, and make the sound, an inhalation, exhalation, fully exhaling, fully inhaling, as powerfully as you can, but without jerking the abdomen, another 21 times with the tongue rolled up. Throughout the whole process, you have your eyes closed, you inhale fully, and simply sit there with the fullness of breath for 1 minute. If you are beyond a certain age or your breathing is not that good, at least 30 seconds. If you're not able to do 1 minute, a minimum of 30 seconds you stay there. When the day you're not able to do it, you must understand that there is some problem with your respiratory system and you must go for a checkup.
Ha ha ha!
So what's being done is one has to sit in a cross-legged posture, whichever way you can, whatever your body permits, and then use both the arms to push it up in such a way that your rib cage lifts off the diaphragm region, fully pushed up, and now extend your tongue fully out. Like this 21 times. When it's done, then close your mouth, that also 21 times, then close your mouth. You exhale with your mouth closed, making the sound at the pit of your throat by creating a constriction. And then if you wish to sit quietly for some time with your eyes closed, do that, and then you can do whatever you're doing. This is a simple practice that anybody could do. You ensure your stomach is not too full, you must be somewhat hungry. Even if you're not totally empty stomach, at least you must be somewhat hungry kind of situation. This is a simple practice, particularly those of you who are exposed either because you are medical personnel or you're police or you're in some other service where you're exposed to infected people. Please make sure you do this, this will make a lot of difference for you.
Le istruzioni per la pratica saranno disponibili online per tuo riferimento. Per favore esegui la pratica esattamente come viene insegnata. Non fare nessun cambiamento o modifica, come incrementare il numero dei cicli. Chiunque tra i 6 e i 70 anni può fare questa pratica, indipendentemente dalle loro condizioni fisiologiche e mediche. Anche chi ha un'età inferiore a 6 anni e chi ha un'età superiore a 70 può fare la pratica, ma deve fare la respirazione 12 volte, non 21. Le persone che hanno o hanno avuto qualsiasi tipo di tumore al cervello o emorragia al cervello possono fare la pratica, ma devono fare la respirazione 12 volte, non 21.